What's good, YouTube? It's your boy SeriousMindsTV back in here with another video, man. And I know y'all see the title of the video and y'all might think I'm tripping, I'm bugging, I'm this and I'm that. But by the end of the video, I really want you guys to just understand the logic that I'm coming from and to realize that this is just an opinion from a basketball fan's perspective. Now, the title of the video, as you see, is James Harden's style of play won't win any championships. Now, don't get me wrong, all right? This is not a video to bash or diss James Harden or none of that. This is just a basketball fan's opinion, and I hope by the end of the video, y'all can understand why I titled the video this way. Now, James Harden has had a great start to start the season, all right? Now, this season so far, he is already averaging 38.7 points per game. Now, in the Rockets' 12 games, in 9 of those games, he has already scored 30 or more points. Now, however, now watching the Rockets play and seeing James Harden play, I've noticed a few things. I feel like these things are going to hamper the Rockets if they want to make a deep playoff run. Now, a lot of times James Harden will do isolation basketball. That's the type of player that he is. You know, he likes to do his little dribble moves and get to the lane and draw contact to get to the foul line or get a layup, or he does his patented step back three, and he even added a one-legged three in his arsenal in the offseason. I really do feel like this style of play is going to hurt the Rockets in the long run. They got Russell Westbrook beside Harden, but honestly, Harden is playing like Westbrook isn't there. Alright, now Kobe said this last year, like he made the same point that I'm making, and I want to take a look back into the history books of the NBA to dive deep into some of the highest scoring seasons in the NBA, and I want to see how they fared as the playoffs went on. Now let's look at Wilt Chamberlain's 1961-1962 NBA season. That season, Wilt averaged 50.4 points a game. That season was highlighted by his historic 100-point game. Now, in the playoffs, Wilt didn't make it to the finals, you know what I'm saying? Now, let's fast forward to the 1986-1987 NBA season. Michael Jordan was the scoring leader that season. He averaged 37.1 points per game. Now, the interesting part about that season was he scored those points. He only took 12 three-pointers in that season, which is a phenomenal feat in itself. You look at this game nowadays, everybody is stuck behind a three-point line just jacking up threes. But in the playoffs, the Bulls lost to the Celtics in the first round, and that was Michael Jordan's third straight first-round exit in the playoffs. So let's go to the 2005-2006 NBA season and look at Kobe Bryant. Now, Kobe Bryant averaged 35.4 points per game, and that season was highlighted by his 81-point performance versus the Toronto Raptors. Now, the Lakers was up 3-1 against the Phoenix Suns in the playoffs, but they lost that 3-1 lead to the Suns, and they took a first-round exit. Now, and you can go to James Harden's season last year, where he averaged 36.1 points per game, and they lost to the Warriors in the second round of the playoffs. So, if you look at the trend, it looks like these players score a lot of points in the regular season, but by the time the playoffs come, it's like they're worn out. In my opinion, James Harden must entrust his teammates to take some of that offensive slack off of him. He has to take a page out of Michael Jordan's playbook. In the 1990-91 season, Michael Jordan began to trust his teammates, and as you saw that season, the Bulls won their first NBA championship due to the fact that Michael started to give some of his players, or his teammates, I should say, some of the offensive slack, and he began to trust his teammates, and that's why the Bulls won the championship that season. Now, I'm not saying that James Harden can't do that, but I feel like he must do so in order for the Rockets to make a strong push in the playoffs. I would love to see the Rockets in the finals. I would love that. But I feel like if this style of play keeps up, it would be good in the regular season, but when crunch time comes in the playoffs, I think this won't work, because let's look at the NBA playoffs per se. The NBA playoffs is all about game-to-game adjustments. So James Harden can score 45 in game one, but in game two, the opposing coach has already made adjustments on how to stop Harden, and that point total can decrease. Because when you're looking in a playoff series, you play a team anywhere from 4 to 7 times. And like I said, each game adjustments are made, so James Harden must make the necessary adjustments to trust his teammates. He has another all-star beside him in Russell Westbrook. So he, instead of dropping 40 to 50 each game, why don't just drop at least like 25, let Russell get 25, and it could be an even distribution. And I'm pretty sure they can, you know, entrust some of the other teammates to carry some of that offensive slack as well. But I just feel like in order for James Harden to get to the finals for the second time and win, he has to trust his teammates, and he has to drop some of that offensive slack. I'm not saying he has to stop scoring 30, but just be smart and not play the way that he does, and maybe the Rockets can win an NBA Finals. But hey, man, that's just my opinion. We can agree to disagree. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please do me a big favor. Hit that like button for your boy. Also, be sure and subscribe to the channel for more content, man. We are on our way to 600 subs, so hit that subscribe button for your boy. Also, leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. I really want to know you guys' thoughts and opinions on this subject, man. I really like doing this video because it required me to do some research. I love the game of basketball, and I love the history behind it. So I love just talking about the history of the game that I love the most. So leave your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below, and also be sure to share this video on all your social media as well. So yeah, man, until the next video, it's your boy SeriousMindsTV, and I'm out.